what everything you did, can I go and do it on your profile? Because can I also access your profile? Those account I can access your profile on LinkedIn, or can I access your profile on LinkedIn, check you up and copy, and then copy, you know, like I copy this link and put it on my system, even though, so can I go to your cloud and bring it to my local stuff, work on it and send it back?
Well, what you can do is you can come to my, if it's public, right? Because they're private and then there's public. You can only see what I've set as public, right? Then when you come to my profile, what you could do is you can see here there's this option of saying fork the repo. What this means is that, like, just copy the entire repo so that it becomes mine, right? I think on my public profile I have a repo that was not initially mine. I think during the where is that? No, I no longer have those things. No, I no longer. Oh yeah. Yes, this one you can see here at the very bottom here. I'm just gonna try to highlight this. This was not initially mine, right? But I went to this person's profile or to this person's GitHub page. And I like this repo of the machine learning books. And then I went to that. Then I went to this aspect here of saying fork, and then I fork it, and then it becomes mine. Now I can make changes to this one, but it will not reflect. Those changes will not reflect to the original to Team Hub, for instance, because I got it from Team Hub. It will not reflect on his repo, you know. It will only reflect on my repo. So I just copy that, put it on my profile, and I start working from it from there. Although, unless if I push to him so that he can accept it, because GitHub has that.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
I mean, awesome. Is there any other question with regard to GitHub?
Okay, hi. COVID. Yeah, so I think it's clear. I think when we watched the video where you did them, writing, cloning it from your command line, from your terminal to the codes and all that, I think that's where I have to just go back and watch again and be on
Yeah,
top of that.
okay, cool. I mean, with time, I think once we've done a session or two, another session, I'll create a video where Pesu will share with you, where I'm doing some of the basic commands with GitHub, like when you push in and stuff like that. If you work on somebody simulating something like that, we had one like that, but it was using the old authentication way. So we need to create a new one.
Thank you very much.
Awesome. Percy?
Yes, thank you very much, Mr. Mkobe. So I just want to advise you guys to not be, if you haven't been engaged with GitHub that much. Mkobe use it quite well, I mean, too much. So at some point when he's going through it, he's going to be using some other methods that you might not have to worry about as you are getting started. So in a general sense, GitHub, it's an account where you put your data, in this case notebooks and some files. So you have your folder there. What you want to do is to take your folder from the internet and put it on your local laptop, work on it, and take it back to the internet. So you only need to know few codes. You can even count them using one hand. You just need to clone your repo into your local laptop. Once it's in your local laptop, you can forget about the terminal and use your laptop as you know. You use your file to navigate through all those files you've seen on your GitHub account. Once after you are done with it, the second step is to take your local work and upload it online. That is pushing your repo. Once you learn how to push your repo, it's just one line of code. Now you know how to take your folder from the internet into your local laptop, then from your local laptop into your repo. Basically, those are the two major commands you need to know. Then from there, that's when you can learn how to fork and how to do other stuff. I'm just trying to help you guys to feel confident and comfortable with it, not to feel overwhelmed by the work, as you can see the pace that you're running through. So he will be creating that video and sharing it with you guys, and you will feel comfortable just going through it and knowing what you have to do. The next step that you are going to move into is how to get your data. In this case, we are using the what is known as the Rapid API from we are going to be scraping our data from IMDb website, which is hosting a lot of information about different kinds of TV shows, from TV series to TV movies and whatnot. So I'm just going to be sharing my screen. There is some few stuff that we will go through together from my side. I just want to know before we go through that, yeah, you are not supposed to see that. I just want to know before we continue, is there any, are you guys okay with the setups? Like, your work environment, are you guys okay with your, maybe Anaconda, if you use Anaconda, you can also use Google Colab. Is there anyone who's having any problems with it? Okay. I will assume that everyone is okay with that. Otherwise, if you can let us know, and then we will assist you in a personal meeting to set that up. So based on our problem statement last week,